Good, are we ready for off?
Yep.
Right. Let's make a thunderous start and M33. The Lord be with you.
And with you.
Amen. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, and from whom no secrets are, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Now we gather together to worship God, and in thanksgiving for the 70 years of faithful service our Sovereign Lady Queen Elizabeth gives to us. Now we give thanks for her example of faithfulness to God and her people, and pray that God's blessing will be on her, that she may continue to fulfill the promises she has made with generosity and joy. Now, gracious God, we give you thanks for the reign of your servant, Elizabeth our Queen, and for the example of loving and faithful service which she has shown among us. Help us to follow her example of dedication and to commit our lives to you and to one another, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Now in our prayers and business, let's think for a moment and recall those things where we have fallen short of what Jesus wants us to be, and say together on page 3. Pray that write it. Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Now we say the Gloria together. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, heavenly King, God the Father Almighty, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of God, Lord God, thou my God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, receive our prayer. You alone are holy, you alone are Lord, you alone are the most high, Jesus Christ, the King of our Spirit, and the glory of God the Father. Christ.
Call it for today, Whit Sunday. God, who as at this time didst teach the hearts of thy faithful people by the sending to them the light of thy Holy Spirit, grant us by the same Spirit to have a right judgment in all things, and evermore to rejoice in his holy comfort. Through the merits of Christ Jesus our Saviour, who liveth and reigneth with thee in the unity of the same Spirit, one God, world without end. Amen.
Amen.
This Old Testament reading is taken from Acts 2, verses 1 to 21. When the day of Pentecost had come, they were all together in one place, and suddenly, from heaven, came a sound like the rush of a violent wind, and it filled the entire house where they were sitting. Divided tongues, as of fire, appeared among them, and a tongue rested on each of them. All of them were filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak in other languages as the Spirit gave them ability. Now there were devout Jews from every nation under heaven living in Jerusalem. And this sound, the crowd gathered and was bewildered, because each one heard them speaking in the native language of each. Amazed and astonished, they asked, "Are not all of these who are speaking Galileans? And how is it that we hear of Mesopotamia, Judea, and Cappadocia, Pontus, Asia, Phrygia, and Rome, Pamphylia, Egypt, and the parts of Libya belonging to Cyrene and visitors from Rome, both Jews and proselytes, Cretans and Arabs? In our own languages we hear them speaking about God's deeds of power." All were amazed and perplexed, saying to one another, "What does this mean?" But others sneered and said, "They are filled with new wine." But Peter, standing with the 11, raised his voice and addressed them. "Men of Judea and all who live in Jerusalem, let this be known to you and listen to what I say. Indeed, these are not drunk as you suppose, for it is only 9 o'clock in the morning. No, this is what was spoken through the prophet Joel. In the last days it will be, God declares, that I will pour out my Spirit upon all flesh, and your sons and your daughters shall prophesy, and your young men shall see visions, and your old men shall dream dreams, even upon my slaves, both men and women. In those days I will pour out my Spirit, and they shall prophesy, and I will show portents in the heaven above, and signs on the earth below, blood and fire and smoky mist. The sun shall be turned to darkness, and the moon to blood, before the coming of the Lord's great and glorious day. Then everyone who calls on the name of the Lord shall be saved. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Good, thank you for the reading. Let's sing now hymn number 87.
We have a second reading.
Right. I'm in full surrender.
The second reading is taken from Romans chapter 8, verses beginning at verse 12. Therefore, brothers, we have an obligation, but it is not to the sinful nature to live according to it. For if you live according to the sinful nature, you will die. But if by the Spirit you put to death the misdeeds of the body, you will live. Because those who are led by the Spirit of God are sons of God. For you did not receive the Spirit that makes you a slave again to fear, but you receive the Spirit of sonship, and by him we cry, Abba, Father. The Spirit himself testifies with our spirit that we are God's children. Now, if we are children, then we are heirs, heirs of God, and co-heirs with Christ, if indeed we share in his sufferings, in order that we may share also in his glory. This is the word of the Lord.
Good, thank you very much for that. Continue with him, 87.
The Gospel is written in the book of John.
Glory.
We begin at chapter 14, verse 8. Philip said, Lord, show us the Father, and that will be enough for us. Jesus answered, Don't you know me, Philip? Even after I have been among you such a long time, anyone who has seen me has seen the Father. How can you say, show us the Father? Don't you believe that I am in the Father, and that the Father is in me? The words I say to you are not just my own. Rather, it is the Father living in me who is doing his work. Believe me when I say that I am in the Father and the Father is in me. Or at least, believe on the evidence of the miracles themselves. I tell you the truth. Anyone who has faith in me will do what I have been doing. He will do even greater things than these, because I am going to the Father. And I will do whatever you ask in my name, so that the Son may bring glory to the Father. You may ask me for anything in my name, and I will do it. All this I have spoken while still with you, but the Counselor, the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name, will teach you all things and will remind you of everything. I have said to you, peace I leave with you, my peace I give you. I do not give to you as the world gives. Do not let your hearts be troubled, and do not be afraid. Praise to you, O Christ.
Good, thank you, Frank. Can you all just sit down, please, if you're not doing so already? Now, you may think we've been pushing around, doing nothing at all, but that's what we're here for. But we are here to try to learn how to love our life and to love our church. And to love each other. So let's love it and know it and share it. Great gifts God has given us. Not only the good things of life, but being able to share it with one another. So when I was thinking of this little talk, I asked myself, how can I live for God? When I put that question to him, he replied, clothe yourself with my love. Take the shirt or dress of my compassion, so that in the cold world you will be warm enough to heal and soothe as I do. And over everything, wear love. And that will clothe you with goodness. And while I was trying to digest that, I asked again, but how can I serve you? And God replied, clothe yourself with my love. Wear kindness on your hands like gloves. And do unseen things for others. You may hurt and blister your hands, but remember, my hands too were pierced. And put on gentleness as shoes, so that you may walk with quiet feet amongst the fragile hopes and dreams of others and their lives. And while I was thinking of that, I remembered Psalm 23. I will lift up mine eyes unto the hills, from whence cometh my help. So I approached him and asked my Lord again, how can I be like you today? And then he touched me and said, clothe yourself with my love. Wear a coat of humility, woven on the warp and weft of me, which makes you holy and proud to be so. And fasten the belt of patience around you to hold you firm and cold when the wind is cold and the wind of criticism blows against you. And over everything, where am I loved? And as my questions continued, he smiled and said, I am your garment of love. Gather me round you and let me share my day with you. And over everything, let there be love. So, all of us here, you and I, dressing up or down, must think about what we are wearing and how we should wear it. And the well-dressed Christian wears the Beatitudes, the blessings of God. That's the best suit to put on. And wear something we can share when God is with us. So that when God is with us, we, his creatures, can focus on God. That's our real place in life, to understand the meaning of every moment. Focus on God. And he is our real creator, who will recreate every single moment for us as we need it. And that's why we come to church together, to celebrate the meaning and purpose of our lives together. And that is our church and the meaning of the message we have to try to share and understand together today. And the simplicity of that message is that love, the love of God, conquers all, not love of money or power or possession or anything that's advertised. But that we are here with God to learn how to love each other. And that's the only equation in life that we can balance, because it helps us to understand the meaning and the purpose of our lives. Love, which is God, is all we need to know and to share our lives with him is all we need to do. So let's try and share it. Allow God to come into our lives. Let him uplift us so that we can face every moment of every day and be loving as he loves us, caring as he cares for us. And all we need to do and all we need to know in our lives is that we are given to share. That's the whole purpose of while we live together. To share the light that's given to us, to enrich it, to uplift it, to be able to help each other, to carry whatever we have to carry. So let me just finish by saying, we should in our lives pray and be refocused in our lives every moment we can. And then we are living life together. Okay. Together, so perhaps let's stand if we can. That's on page number 7. And we say together, we believe in
in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten and not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation he came down from heaven, was incarnate of the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and was made man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again,
according to the Scriptures.
Yes, ascended to heaven, and he seated at the right hand of his Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who was spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and look for the resurrection of the dead, and the life of the world to come.
Sit down and kneel down. We shall have our prayer of intercession.
Good morning. When you hear the words Holy Father, Father, after the prayer, each prayer chapter, please say, hear our prayer. Holy Father, we thank you for our Queen Elizabeth II in this her Platinum Jubilee year. We thank you for her service to you, our God, and to her country and people of the Commonwealth across the world. We thank you for the Queen's loyalty, her enduring duty through times of turbulence, trouble and terror. Her grace, her strength and integrity are a beacon to us all. We thank you for giving us a true leader of nations. Holy Father,
hear our prayer.
We thank you for the Queen's faith in you, God. She has attributed her faith as the source of strength and guidance to enable her to do her role and be the Queen. You have been her constant companion and rock. Holy Father,
hear our prayer.
We pray for the Queen's health as she continues to serve and work in her 96th year of life. We pray you give her relief and comfort in her body to carry out her active duties and allow her the freedom to enjoy her hobbies, including the riding and walking which she dearly loves. And we pray also for the health of our rector who has been fighting for his life. We pray for his continued improvement so he can continue his life as a husband to Carol, father and grandfather to his children, and continue his work for God. And we take a personal moment to pray for anybody else that's close to us or known to us who may be sick. We pray for the Queen and her family for their grief and loss of losing Prince Philip, who was her husband, father, grandfather and Queen's consort, and the longest serving. We take a moment to pray for those we know and love, who we have lost and whose grief is ever before them. Merciful Father,
accept these prayers
for the sake of your Son,
our Saviour Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Well, thank you, Joe. I appreciate that offering. now, whether standing or sitting or doing whatever you like, let's try and share our peace together. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
And do it with a smile. We move to page number 35. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
Give thanks to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It grant your thanks and praise.
Blessed are you, Lord God, our light and our salvation. To you be glory and praise forever. From the beginning, you have created all things, and all your works echo the silent music of your praise. In the fullness of time, you made us in your own image, the crown of all creation. You gave us breath and speech, that with angels and archangels and all the powers of heaven, we may find a voice to sing your praise. Holy, holy, holy Lord,
Father, power of might, heaven and earth are full of your glory, and stand in your hearts. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, and stand in the hearts.
A wonderful work of your hands, O Lord. As a mother tenderly gathers her children, you embrace a people as your own. When they turn away and rebelled, your love remains steadfast. From them you raise up Jesus our Saviour, born of Mary, to be the living bread, in whom all our hungers are satisfied. He offered his life for sinners, and with a love stronger than death, he opened wide his arms on the cross. On the nights before he died, he came to supper with his friends, taking the bread, he gave you things, he broke it, and gave it to them, saying, take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. At the end of supper, taking the cup of wine, he gave you thanks, and said, drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. Christ has died.
Christ is risen.
Christ will come again. Father, we plead with confidence his sacrifice made once for all upon the cross. We remember his dying and rising in glory, and we rejoice that he intercedes for us at your right hand. Pour out your Holy Spirit as we bring before you these gifts of your creation. May they be for us the body and blood of your dear Son. As we eat and drink these holy gifts in your presence, form us in the likeness of Christ and build us into the living memory of your glory. Bring us at the last with all the saints to the vision of that eternal splendor which you have created us, through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom, and with whom, and in whom, with all who stand before you in earth and heaven, we worship you, Father Almighty, in songs of everlasting praise. Blessing and honor and glory be yours forever and ever. Turn to page number 12 and say our Lord's Prayer together.
hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory. Break this bread. To share in the body of Christ.
And though we are many, we are one body, because we all share one bread.
And every time we break this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim the Lord's death until he comes. Lamb of God, to take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, grant us peace. And draw near with faith. Receive the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which he gave for you, and his blood, which he shed for you. Eat and drink in remembrance that he died for you. Feed on him in your hearts by faith with thanksgiving. And God's holy gifts, God's holy gifts. We do not presume to come to this your table, merciful Lord, trusting in our own righteousness, but in your manifold and great mercies. We are not worthy so much as to gather the crumbs of your table, but you are the same Lord, who blesses it always to have mercy. Grant us, therefore, gracious Lord, so to eat the flesh of your dear Son, Jesus Christ, and to drink his blood, that our sinful bodies may be made clean by his body, and our souls washed through his most precious blood, that we may evermore dwell in him and he in us.